Hello. Hello, friends. How are you? Hello, friends. God loves you. And so do I. Good morning. Well, today's story is a great one. Last week we talked about Jesus as a little boy. And there aren't that many stories in the Bible about Jesus as a little boy. So we're going to fast forward when Jesus was about 30 years old. And it's the story about Jesus and John the Baptist. It's taken from the Read and Learn Bible and from the book of Luke in the Bible. Jesus and John the Baptist. Years went by, and Jesus was 30 years old. He lived in Nazareth and worked as a carpenter. But his life was about to change. He was about to start the work that he had been born to do. So Jesus's daddy on earth was Joseph, and he was a carpenter. So he probably learned how to be a carpenter from his daddy. Well, this is a picture of John the Baptist. John, the son of Elizabeth and Zechariah, who was Jesus's cousin, was 30 years old too, and God's Spirit had given him great power. John lived alone in the desert, and his clothes were made of camel's hair. And he wore a strap of leather around his waist as a belt. And he ate wild honey and whatever else he could find, even grasshoppers. So then God told John to go to the valley of the Jordan River and preach to the people. So he left the desert and he went to the River Jordan. And there he is preaching. Well, John said to the people, "Turn back to God. Come into the river with me, and your sins will be washed away, and you will be forgiven." Well, crowds of people came to the river, and John told them that being baptized was really not enough. They must do something to show that they had really given up all their sins. So he said they must be honest and fair, and they must be kind to the poor. "If you have two coats," he said, "you give one to someone who doesn't have one. And if you have food, share it with someone else." So I think he was telling them, you can get your sins washed away by baptism in the river, but you also need to live a good Christian life and take care of others and follow the 10 best ways to live, which are the 10 commandments. Well, everyone wondered if John could be the savior they had been waiting for. But John said, "No, it's not me. Someone more powerful than I is going to come. I'm not good enough to even untie his sandals. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." John took one person after another into the river, and he held their hands and he dipped them under the water. And while he was baptizing people this way, Jesus came. And he asked John to baptize him. Well, John did not think he should do that. "I ought to be baptized by you," he said to Jesus. But Jesus said, "This is what God wanted them to do." So, it says here that baptism is a word that means to dip in water. So when you hear baptism, it means to dip in water. And then the people were baptized to show that they wanted to stop sinning and be made clean by God's forgiveness. I love this next picture. So, John baptized Jesus in the Jordan River. And then Jesus prayed, and the sky opened up, and the Holy Spirit came down upon him. And it looked like a dove. A voice from heaven said, "You are my own dear son, and I am pleased with you." So, the skies opened up and a dove came down, and the Holy Spirit spoke. And the Holy Spirit is God's presence at work in the world. And Jesus promised to send the Holy Spirit to guide people in the full truth. So that's the story of how John the Baptist, Jesus's cousin, baptized him. And then I think Jesus's life really changed. I don't think he was just going to be the carpenter anymore. I think he was going to start his ministry. And when he did start his ministry, he needed some help. He couldn't do it all by himself. So he got some helpers, some followers. Sometimes we use the word disciple. And that will be our story next time. So let's end in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you so much for sending John the Baptist to baptize Jesus. And thank you for your Holy Spirit to help us always to remember to do the right thing and follow the 10 best ways. Amen. Well, it's supposed to be snowing in the next few days, so I hope you have a wonderful time playing in the snow. Get all bundled up nice and warm and then go out and run around. And then when you get cold, come back inside and have some hot chocolate. That's the best part, I'm told, of snow days, the hot chocolate. So until we see each other again, stay well, be happy, stay healthy, and until next time, just remember, God loves you, and so do I. Take care.